Hello students, good afternoon. So last time we were discussing about matrix. I also told you the additions and subtractions of matrix. Today we shall start the multiplication of matrix. Okay? So multiplication of matrix. How do you multiply the matrix? So you must understand it properly, because this is more important. Now multiplication of matrix means two types of multiplication. One is, this is multiplication of matrix. The first one is scalar multiplication. Scalar multiplication. The word scalar means a constant. Okay? The word scalar means a constant. Now when we multiply a constant to each and every element of the matrix, that multiplication is called as scalar matrix or scalar multiplication. Okay? A scalar is to be multiplied with every element of the matrix. Let's see. Let's say matrix A, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Okay? This is matrix A. And let's say k is equal to 5. K means a constant, which you call as scalar. So now if I say, what will be ka? What will be ka? K means a constant multiplied with A matrix. Now, then k will be 5 multiplied with this matrix, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. That will be equal to 5 multiplied with each element of the matrix. That is, you see here, 5 into 1, then this is 5 into 2, 5 into 3, then 5 into 4, 5 into 5, then 5 into 6, then 7 into 5, and 5 into 8, and 5 into 9. Okay, now you see here, we have multiplied this scalar 5 with every element of the matrix A. So now the result is 5 into 1 is 5, 5 into 2 is 10, 5 into 3 is 15, 5 into 4 is 20, 5 into 5 is 25, 5 into 6 is 30, 5 into 7 is 35, 5 into 8 is 40, 5 into 9 is 45. So this is Ka. Okay, this is Ka. That is a constant multiplied with matrix A. This is called scalar multiplication. This is very simple, that we simply multiply a constant with a particular matrix. Means that constant to be multiplied with every element of the matrix, we call it as scalar matrix, right? So this is the first one, which you call as scalar multiplication. Now the second one is called as multiplication proper. Multiplication proper. This is called multiplication proper. Now what is multiplication proper? Multiplication proper means this is the real multiplication of matrix. Okay, this is the real multiplication of matrix, where we multiply two matrix, not with a scalar, we multiply each element of a matrix with the other element of the matrix. Now multiplication proper, in what condition multiplication proper is possible? Remember, this is important. In what condition multiplication proper is possible? Now there is only one condition. The condition is two matrix can have multiplication proper if and only if the number of columns of the first matrix is equal to the number of rows of the second matrix. That is, the number of columns of the first matrix will be equal to the number of rows of the first matrix, of the second matrix. So first matrix row जितेटा कलम थी सेकेंड मैट्रिक्स सेतेटा रो थी ताहले केवल मल्टीप्लिकेशन प्रॉपर इज पॉसिबल अदरवाइज मल्टीप्लिकेशन प्रॉपर विल नॉट बी पॉसिबल सो ए मैट्रिक्स जितेटा कलम थी बी मैट्रिक्स सेतेटा रो थी राइट सेकेंड कथा होची किंतु मल्टीप्लिकेशन कला बेले आमे सब रो को कलम सांगे मल्टीप्लाई करवा रो मल्टीप्लाइड इंटू कलम किंतु कंडीशन कौन ना कलम शुड बी इक्वल टू रोज बट व्हेन वी मल्टीप्लाई द रोज विल बी मल्टीप्लाइड इंटू कलम्स ओके लेट अस टेक द एग्जांपल लेट्स से ए मैट्रिक्स इज 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 and 9 दिस इज मैट्रिक्स ए एंड B matrix, let's say, you can take anything, it's not that. So let's say, 7, 8, 5, 6, 2, 1, 1, 8, 2. Now this is 3 into 3 and this is also 3 into 3. Two matrix. Now because here, the rows and columns of both matrix are same. Here the first column has 3 rows, the second column has also 3 rows. First matrix has 3 columns, second matrix has also 3 columns. So our condition is satisfied. Now we can go to multiply the matrix A with B. So how we can multiply A with B? How it will be A into B? Let's see. How do you multiply? I told you, when we multiply rows with columns. Because you are multiplying A with B, so the rows of A will be multiplied with the columns of B. A has 3 rows, B has 3 columns, okay? So first row to be multiplied with first row to be multiplied with the first column, again first row with the second column, again first row with the third column, again second row with first column, second row with second column, and second row with third column. So it will be a lengthier one. Just look how I do. First we take this first row with the first column. That is 1 into 7 plus 2 into 6. This is 2, this is 6. Then plus 3 into 1. Okay? You see, every element of the first row is multiplied with every element of the first column. Now coming to the second column again. 1 into 8 plus 2 into 2 plus 3 into 8. Now coming to the first row and third column. 1 into 5 plus 2 into 1 plus 3 into 2. So the first row we have multiplied with the first column, second column, and also third column. Now we come to the second row. See here, 4 into again 7 plus 5 into 6 plus 6 into 1. Then coming to second row, second column, 4 into 8 plus 5 into 2 plus 6 into 8. Then come to the third column, 4 into 5 plus 5 into 1 plus 6 into 2. Now coming to the third one, third row, 7 into 7 plus 8 into 6 plus 9 into 1. Again, 7 into 8 plus 8 into 2 plus 9 into 9 into 8. Again, 7 into 5 plus 8 into 1 plus 9 into 2. Okay? The third row we have multiplied with the first column, second column, and also third column. Now, let us solve it. this we have to write in one number. 7 plus 12. 7 12 is 19 plus 3. This is 22. Again coming here, 8 plus 4, 12 plus 24. 24, 12 is 36. 36, here is 5 plus 2, 7. 7 plus 3, 6. This is 13. Again here, 7, 4 is 28. This is 30. 28, 30 is 58. 58, 6, 64. Again, 32, 10, 42, 42 and 48 is 90. Then 20, 25, 25, 12, 37. Next is 49, this is 48. 49, 48, 95 plus 9, 95, 9, 104. This is 48, 56, then this is 16, 56, 16, 60, 72, 72 and again 72, 72, 72, 144. And this is 35, 8, 43, 43, 18, 43, 18 is 61. So this is A into B. Now you see here, we have written systematically, that is each row multiplied with each column. Each row, three rows and three columns we have multiplied here, and finally we get the result that this A into B is equal to 22, 36, 13, 64, 90, 37, 104, 144 and 61. So this is how we have to multiply two matrix, that is two matrix multiplication is possible if and only if the number of columns of the first matrix is equal to the number of rows of the second matrix. Okay, if this is not satisfied, then multiplication is not possible. Okay, therefore you must see that first, whether it is possible or not, and after when you go to multiply, you try to multiply each row with each column. Okay, each row means each element of the first row to be multiplied with each element of the first column. That is 1 into 7, 2 into 6, 3 into 1. Again, 1 into 8, 2 into 2 and 3 into 8. Again, 1 into 5, 2 into 1 and 3 into 2. So this is how we conduct the multiplication of matrix. I hope you understand it. Next time when I come, I shall go again with some other examples how to multiply two different types of matrix. Okay, thank you. Thank you. Please watch the videos till the end and tell your friends also to watch it, because this is the only platform through which I shall take your classes. I will not go for Google Meet, I shall not go for Zoom, etc. I will only take class here. Okay, thank you.